Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 7.4. We are going to solve problems in the bevel gear design using the PSG design data book. In the earlier two lectures also, we solved four problems in the design of bevel gear. And we solved two more problems in the design of bevel gear in this lecture. And the example number 5 from November 2015 question paper. Two state bevel gears are used in a speed reducer with a transmission ratio of 2. The wheel is supported on both sides and the pinion is overhanging. The input is from a 20 kilowatt electric motor running at 950 rpm. The material for pinion and the wheel are toll Ni 2Cr1 MO15. It is an alloy steel. Design the bevel gears. So the given data for the problem, the power is 20 kilowatt, pinion speed is 950 rpm, speed reduction is 2, material is toll Ni 2Cr1 MO15. So we calculate the speed ratio. It is given in the problem, it is 2. And the material for the pinion and the gear is also given here. It is an alloy steel. And we take the property from table number 1.40, PSG data book. Tensile strength sigma equal to 10,400 kilogram force per centimeter square. And BHN is 630. It is case hardened. The BHN value is greater than 350 now. Then we calculate the nominal twisting moment. So MT equal to 97,420 into power in kilowatt divided by the pinion speed. So 97,420 into 20 divided by 950 equal to 2050.9 kilogram force centimeter. Then we calculate the design torque. We take initially KKD equal to 1.3. The design torque equal to MT twisting moment into KKD 2050.9 into 1.3 equal to 2666.2 kilogram force centimeter. Then we take the equivalent Young's modulus for the material. It is steel for both. Alloy steel for both pinion and the gear. So, equivalent X modulus is 2.15 in 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square from table number 9, page 8.14. Then we take the design, calculate the design surface stress. The equation is available in the page number 8.16. For steel, surface hardened, CR, coefficient CR equal to 55, Rockwell C hardness number is 230, and the KCL life factor we assume 1. So, design surface stress. CR, HRC, KCL, 55 into 230 into 1 equal to 12,650 kilogram force per centimeter square. And we take psi y equal to 3 for the I value 2 from the page number 8.15, table 13. Then we calculate the minimum cone distance. The equation is available in the page number 8.13, table number 8. R is greater than or equal to psi y into I square plus 1 to the power 0.5 into cubic root of 0.72 divided by psi y minus 0.5 into design surface stress whole square into E into MT divided by I. Substituting numerical values, R is greater than or equal to 3 into 2 square plus 1 to the power 0.5 into cubic root of 0.72 divided by 3 minus 0.5 into 12,650 whole square into 2.15 in 10 power 6 into 2,666.2 divided by 2. So, the R value should be greater than or equal to 7.65 centimeter. Then we calculate the bending stress, design bending stress. For calculating design bending stress, we require all the information. The life factor for bending, it is 0.7 when the BHN value is greater than 350. K sigma stress concentration factor is 1.2 for steel. N factor of safety equal to 2 for steel. And the endurance limit stress. For steel, it is sigma minus 1, 0.35 into sigma u plus 1200. This is 0.35 into 10,400 plus 1200 equal to 4,840 kilogram force per centimeter square. Now, we calculate the design bending stress. The equation is available in the page number 8.18. Sigma b equal to 1.4 into KBL divided by n into K sigma into sigma minus 1. Substituting 1.4 into 0.7 divided by 2 into 1.2 into 4840 equal to 1976.3 kilogram force per centimeter square. Then we calculate the, take the number of teeth of the pinion. We take Z1 equal to 20 and the virtual number of teeth of the pinion. So first we calculate delta 1. Delta 1 equal to tan inverse of 1 by I, which is tan inverse of 1 by 2 equal to 26.56. So ZV equal to Z1 divided by cos delta 1. So 20 divided by cos of 26.56 equal to 22.3. Now we take the form factor for 22. ZV equal to 22.33 from table number 40, page number 8.53. Then we calculate the average module. The equation is available in the page number 8.13a. We take psi m equal to 10 for our calculation. The average module m average greater than or equal to 1.28 into mt divided by yv bending stress psi m into z1 to the power 1 by 3. Substituting numerical values, average module is greater than or equal to 1.28 into 2666.2 divided by 0.33 into 1976.3 into 10 into 20 to the power 1 by 3, which is 0.35. So the module, average module should be greater than 0.35. So we take the transverse module. So to calculate the transverse module, we require B value. So B equal to R divided by psi y, 7.65 divided by 3 equal to 2.55. The transverse module equal to average module plus B by Z1 sin delta 1, which is 0.35 plus 0.255 divided by 20 into sin 26.56 equal to 0.41 centimeter. Now we have to take the standard module for the transverse module. The from table number 1, page number 8.2, mt equal to 0.45 centimeter or 4.5 millimeter, the next higher value from the table. Then we calculate the following properties of the bevel gear drive. Number of teeth in the gear, Z2 equal to I into Z1, 2 into 20 equal to 40. PCD of the pinion, D1 equal to MT into Z1, so 0.45 into 20 equal to 9 centimeter. PCD of the gear, MT into Z2, 0.45 into 40 equal to 18 centimeter. Tip diameter of the pinion, DA1 equal to MT into Z1 plus 2 into cos delta 1, which is 0.45 into 20 plus cos of 26.56 equal to 9.8 centimeter. And tip diameter of the gear, DA2 equal to MT into Z2 plus 2 cos delta 1, which is 0.45 into 40 plus 2 into cos 26.56 equal to 18.8 centimeter. Then we calculate the cone distance, R equal to 0.5 into MT into square root of Z1 square plus Z2 square, 0.5 into 0.45 into square root of 20 square plus 40 square equal to 10.1 centimeter. And this value is higher than the previous value calculated for the center cone distance. Then we calculate the face width. There are two equations for the face width. B is equal to R by psi y, 10.1 divided by 3 equal to 3.37 centimeter. And B is also equal to 10 into MT, 10 into 0.45 equal to 4.5 centimeter. And we fix B equal to 3.37 centimeter, the smaller value among these two. Then we have to check the design. So for checking, we require the average pitch diameter of the bevel pinion. D1 average equal to MT into Z1 into R minus 0.5 divided by 0.5B divided by R. Substituting 0.45 into 20 into 10.1 minus 0.5 into 3.37 divided by 10.1 equal to 7.5 centimeter. And B by D1 average equal to 3.37 divided by 7.5 equal to 0.45. Then the load concentration factor from table number 14, it is equal to 1.6 for BHN value greater than 350 and B by D1 average is equal to 0.45. Then we calculate the pitch line velocity, V equal to pi D1 average N1 divided by 60, pi into 0.075 into 950 divided by 60 equal to 3.7 meters per second. And the dynamic load factor equal to 1.25 where velocity equal to 3.7 meters per second. And BHN value greater than 350. Then we calculate the design torque for checking purpose. So MT twisting moment into KKD. So 2050.9 into 1.6 into 1.25 equal to 4101.8 kilogram 4 centimeter. Then checking for the surface stress, sigma c equal to 0.72 divided by R minus 0.5b into square root of I square plus 1 to the power 1.5 divided by IB into E into MT. So substituting all numerical values, 0.72 divided by 10.1 minus 0.5 into 3.37 into square root of 2 square plus 1 to the power 1.5 divided by 2 into 3.37 into 2.15 into 10 power 6 into 4101.8. Calculating, the actual surface stress is 10,348.6, which is less than the 12,650, the design surface stress. So, the design is safe. With respect to the compressive stress, the design is safe. Then we check for the bending stress. We take pressure angle always alpha equal to 20 degree. So, checking for the bending stress, sigma b equal to r into square root of I square plus 1 divided by r minus 0.5 b whole square into design torque divided by bmyv cos del alpha. So, substituting 10.1 into square root of 2 square plus 1 divided by 10.1 minus 0.5 into 3.37 whole square into 4101.8 divided by 3.37 into 0.45 into 0.33 into cos 20. So, calculating, it is 2781.8, which is greater than 1976.3. The design bending stress, what we calculated earlier, is 1976.3. So, the value is higher now. So, the actual bending stress is higher than the design bending stress. So, the face width is to be changed for the new bending stress. So, face width, new face width equal to 3.37 divided by 1976.3 into 2781.8 equal to 4.7 centimeter. This is the modification in the design. We take the next problem, example number 6 from now May 2011 question paper. A pair of full 20 degree full depth involute teeth bevel gears connect two shafts at right angles having velocity ratio 3. The gear is made by cast steel having allowable static stress 70 MPa and the pinion is of steel with allowable static stress 100 MPa. The pinion transmits 37.5 kW at 750 rpm. Determine module, face width and pitch diameter. Assume tooth form factor y equal to 0.154 minus 0.912 divided by ze, where ze is the formality number of teeth. Width equal to 1 by 3 times of length of the pitch cone. These are all the data given. Now, we are not going to follow the conventional design procedure because many of the data are given. So, form factor equation is given, face width is given, b equal to 1 by 3 times of the pitch cone. So, the p equal to power equal to 37.5 kilowatt, pinion speed is 750 rpm, I equal to 3. Material is cast steel for both pinion and the gear. But we design for the pinion material. So, for pinion, the bending stress, static stress is given as 100 MPa, which is 1019.3 kilogram force per centimeter square, and we are given B equal to R by 3. Now, we calculate the speed ratio. It is given 3 is the speed ratio in the problem, and we calculate the nominal twisting moment. So, MT equal to 97,420 into power in kilowatt divided by N1, the pinion speed. So, 97,420 into 37.5 divided by 750 equal to 4,871 kilogram per centimeter. Then we calculate the design torque, initially assuming KKD equal to 1.3. So, design torque, nominal twisting moment into KKD, 4,871 into 1.3 equal to 6,332.6 kilogram per centimeter. Then we take the equivalent Young's modulus for steel. It is cast steel for both pinion and the gear. So, E equal to 2.15 10 power 6 kilogram force per centimeter square. Psi equal to 3 for I equal to 2 from table number 13. And design bending stress is given in the problem. Sigma B equal to 1091.3 kilogram force per centimeter square for pinion material given in the problem. And number of teeth, we assume 20 for the pinion. And the virtual number of teeth of the pinion, we calculate delta 1 equal to tan inverse of 1 by I. Tan inverse of 1 by 3 equal to 18.43. And ZV equal to Z1 by cos delta 1, which is 20 divided by cos of 18.43 equal to 21. Now, we calculate the form factor. So, form factor equation is given YV equal to 0.154 minus 0.912 divided by ZV, ZE, virtual number of teeth. So, 0.154 minus 0.912 divided by 21 equal to 0.11. Form factor equal to 0.11. And average module, we calculate using this equation. Average module equal, greater than or equal to 1.28 into design torque divided by YV, sigma B, psi M, Z1 to the power 1 by 3 in centimeter. Substituting, it is 1.28 into 6332.6 divided by 0.11 into 1019.3 into 10 into 20, which is 0.84 centimeter. Number of teeth in the gear, Z2 equal to IEZ1, 3 into 20 equal to 60, and the transverse module, we have to calculate the transverse module. So now we are given R equal to, the equation for cone distance, R equal to 0.5 MT into square root of Z1 square plus Z2 square. We know Z1, Z2 value, we substitute, MT is unknown, R is given 3 times of B. So calculating the phase width B equal to 31.6 times of MT. Now you take the MT equation, transverse module equation, MT equal to M average plus B by Z1 sin delta 1. So substitute MT equal to M average, we have calculated 0.84, 31.6 into MT. So B equal to 31.6 into MT divided by 20 into sin 18.43. So calculating the second term, it is 0.5 times of MT. So rearranging, MT equal to 0.84 divided by 0.5 equal to 1.68 centimeter. The transverse module, actual transverse module is 1.68 centimeter. Now we have to take the next value. So next higher value is 1.8 centimeter or 18 millimeter from the data book. Table number 1, page number 8.2. Now we have to calculate the properties of the bevel gear drive. All the equations are available in the table number 31, page number 8.38. PCD of the pinion, D1 equal to MT into Z1, 1.8 20 equal to 36 centimeter. PCD of the gear, D2 equal to MT into Z2, 1.8 into 60 equal to 108 centimeter. Tip diameter of the pinion, DA1 equal to MT into Z1 plus cos 2 cos delta 1 equal to 1.8 into 20 plus 2 into cos 18.43 equal to 39.4 centimeter. And tip diameter of the gear, DA2 equal to MT into Z1 plus 2 cos delta 1, which is 1.8 into 60 plus 2 into cos 18.43 equal to 111.4 centimeter. Then the cone distance, R equal to 0.5 MT into square root of Z1 square plus Z2 square. So 0.5 into 1.8 into 20 square plus 60 square equal to 56.9 centimeter. And the phase width equal to B equal to R by 3. 56.9 divided by 3 equal to 19 centimeter. So these are all the specification of the drive. Now we have to check the design. So average pitch diameter is required. Average pitch diameter of the bevel pinion, D1 average equal to MT into Z1 into R minus 0.5B divided by capital R, which is 1.8 into 20 into 56.9 minus 0.5 into 19 divided by 56.9 equal to 30 centimeter. So B by D1 average equal to 19 by 30 equal to 0.63. Now the K, load concentration factor from table number 14, it is 1.1 for BHN value less than 350 and B by D1 average is 0.63. And we calculate the pitch line velocity, V equal to pi D1 average N1 divided by 60, which is pi into 0.3 into 750 divided by 60 equal to 11.8 meters per second. Then the dynamic load factor equal to 1.4 for V equal to 11.8 and BHN value less than 350. Then we calculate the design torque for the actual gear designed. So twisting, nominal twisting moment into KKD, 6332.6 into 1.1 into 1.4 equal to 9752.2 kilogram 4 centimeter. Now we have to check for the surface stress. The equation is there in the page number 8.13. Sigma C equal to 0.72 divided by R minus 0.5B into square root of I square plus 1 to the power 1.5 divided by IB into E into the design torque. Substitute numerical values, 0.72 divided by 56.9 minus 0.5 into 19 into square root of 3 square plus 1 to the power 1.5 divided by 3 into 19 into 2.15 into 10 power 6 into 9752.2, calculating 1638.3 kilogram force per centimeter square. Now we have to calculate the design surface stress for BHN for the cast steel is 145. PhD data book table number page number 1.40, CB equal to 16 from table number 16, we take KCL equal to 1. So sigma C equal to design surface is equal to CB HB KCL 25 into 145 equal to 3625. So the actual stress is 1638.3 and design stress is 3625. So the actual compressive stress is less than the design compressive stress. So the design is safe. Then we check for the bending stress. We take pressure angle equal to 20 degree. So sigma b equal to r into square root of I square plus 1 divided by r minus 0.5 whole square into design torque divided by bm yv cos alpha in kilogram force per centimeter square. So the sigma b equal to 56.9 into square root of 3 square plus 1 divided by 56.9 minus 0.5 into 19 whole square into 9752.2 divided by 19 into 1.8 into 0.11 into cos 20. Calculating the bending stress is 220.9, which is less than 1019.3. So the actual bending stress is less than the design bending stress. So the design is safe. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject, and I upload all the video lectures for the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Post your comments, please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture on the subject design of transmission system.